We're joined now by director Gabe Polsky. Gabe, we heard one word Wayne Gretzky say a couple of times in that quick clip, creativity, and that's really the essence of what this film's about.
It is. It's, you know, basically it's about the nature of greatness, and what that is creativity. You know, when we go to the stadium, we're looking for, you know, something we've never seen before. We want to see that magical moment that where you turn to the guy next to you and say, how did he do that? You know, and really the greatest athletes of all time that populate my film, you know, Muhammad Ali, Michael Jordan, Wayne Gretzky, Jerry Rice, these are guys that look at themselves as, you know, artists and creative people, and that's how they became the greatest of all time.
You mentioned you interviewed so many different people here, and obviously Gretz and Jerry Rice and Pele are the feature. But what was the most interesting guy or moment in those interviews?
Well, I mean, there's a lot of interesting moments, and, you know, I think everything's interesting because I don't like, you know, anything boring in a film. But I think, you know, one of the things that really interested me about Wayne Gretzky, we're talking hockey here, is that, you know, he talked about basically remembering every single play of every game he's ever played in. And I couldn't, you know, that basically, when he said that to me, I almost fell off my chair because I just can't even comprehend how someone could do that. And you know, but it's anecdotes like that that populate the entire film. You know, like Jerry Rice, for instance, talking about how he was never late for a single practice and he usually shows up 20 minutes early. You know, things like that. And Pele talking about how basically he would get benched a lot when he was a kid because he was too kind of experimental. And so things like that, you know, I think are going to really surprise people when they see this film. It's not what you expect. You know, greatness, we look at a lot of physical things, size, speed, and strength. It has nothing to do with that. It's all about artistry and about experimentation and play.
But a lot of these guys too, Gabe, you know, we talked yesterday, in fact, on the show about how some of the best players don't end up making great coaches because they can't explain how they did what they did. So these guys might not, I mean, I guess weren't maybe comfortable talking about what they did. Was it more about how they did it and what led them to their greatness? Because it comes in all different forms, too.
Yeah, that's an interesting thing you pointed out, because I did ask Wayne about his coaching career. And he said, whether you like it or not, he said, listen, if I had the Edmonton Oilers in the 1980s, I'd be considered a great coach. You know,
true.
So that's one thing. I think, you know, in terms of explaining it, it is, artistry and creativity is kind of hard to explain. But one thing that these guys did harp on was the fact that they, you know, when they were younger, they played a lot in the backyard. That's where they developed their skills, their creativity, and sort of understood their weaknesses, who they are as people, and were able to develop, basically use their imagination to develop their particular skill set.
And I think, too, as you're talking about, you know, guys never being late to a single practice, and Gretzky, remember, every single play in every single game that he played, and he played in a lot of games.
Yes, he did.
It's that attention to detail that... really comes from passion, genuine passion for their craft. Would you agree?
Yeah, I would agree. I mean, greatness cannot be manufactured. You cannot push a kid to become great. I mean, it has to come from within. It has to be tremendous love, bordering on almost OCD.
Obsessive.
We could call it OCD, whatever you name it. It's that love where they can't stop doing what they're doing. They'd rather play hockey all day long versus go to the movies or do anything with their friends because they just love it. That's what they love doing. And that's something that comes from within. It can't be created in a sports academy or somewhere else. That's what it is.
And that's kind of, too, sorry to jump in, EJ, but we talk about hockey sense a lot. When you guys are talking about the game, he has great hockey sense, great hockey smarts, and that's kind of a part of the game. You could be the fastest, the strongest, have the hardest shot, but if you don't understand the game or you don't have the hockey sense, then you are not going to be, you know, Wayne Gretzky.
Yeah, but the hockey sense, you know, a lot of people, I think, are misinformed about hockey sense because I do believe that it can be developed. It's not something you're necessarily born with. You study the game, you really understand it, you internalize it. It's not an intellectual thing. You know, it becomes an intuitive thing. And,
yes.
And that can be developed. It can be easily developed. But kids think, oh, I either have it or I don't have it. That's not true.
Let me ask you, you brought up the fact that a lot of these guys, you talked about playing as young children, playing outdoors, and the world is changing dramatically now. When I was growing up on different streets, there'd be kids playing touch football or street hockey or different things. Now I drive through neighborhoods, there's never any kids playing on the street. Yeah. What they do now is you're playing when the games are set up for you. It's more formal now.
Yeah.
Is there a concern when you talk to some of these different guys about the future for developing great players and great athletes?
Big concern. I mean, like I said before, listen, you could go to sports academy, you could do these structured drills over and over, but then what happens is you become a robot, okay? You have great technical ability, you've got great physical skills, but you don't have a poetry or an artistry to the game, and that's why we spend money. You know what I'm saying? We're not going there to see technical robots.
Yeah.
We want to see something beautiful.
Flair.
So and a voice.
Yeah.
With that said, you also did the film on the Red Army. All right. So they were you want to talk about a rigid, controlled environment. How then, in your opinion and for your work, do you think they were able to be such a dynamic, dominant team, despite the fact that they were literally, in some ways, forced to do that?
Yeah. So the irony with that is that the coach, Viktor Tikhonov, of this in the 80s of this Russian dynasty, it was so rigid off the ice, but once they got on the ice, they actually had a lot of freedom to do what they did best and be creative. I know Igor Larionov and Fetisov would always say that basically the only time they ever felt free was on the ice together. So when they're on the ice, they were free, but off the ice, it was rigid and a terrible life, basically, yeah.
And that, when that started, though, in watching your film, when it first started, there was a different coach there, and it was a different way of thinking, wasn't it?
Yeah, with Anatoly Tarasov, who was sort of this,
such a guy who was ahead of his time when it came to hockey.
Yeah, I mean, he was a philosopher more than a coach and really kind of studied dance and poetry. Basically, created the beautiful hockey that we saw. But then once he was removed because he basically made the president angry and they fired him.
Couldn't do that in the Soviet
Union. Minor details, right?
Yeah. But after that, it became kind of just very rigid and painfully kind of isolating for the players. Mm.
Now, before we let you go, my understanding, you and Jaffe actually know each other from way back. We need to explain this to the viewers very quickly.
It was 1997, the first ever World Maccabi Games that included ice hockey.
Okay.
In the northernmost, pretty much the northernmost town of Israel, on the border of Israel and Lebanon. Metula is the name. There's a hockey rink up there, a full-sized, it's called the Canada Center, full-fledged hockey rink that they brought in hockey players from, around the world, a few countries. That was it. It was U.S., Canada, Israel had a team, and the Ukraine had a team there as well. We had a great time. What a learning experience.
He was like the elder statesman and
I was the old man.
Was the veteran. And the guy was like, I would just sort of, I hadn't even gone to college yet, so I was scared of Billy.
I still am. I really am.
We had a great time.
I'm scared of him.
We lost to Canada in the gold medal game.
We had a good time.
And then you're talking about remembering details, 5-3 in the gold medal game. To Team Canada. David Nemirovsky led the way for Team Canada.
Yeah. There's a memory right there.
We had him. We had Justin Dubrin, Dave Heimovich. I can remember the whole team.
I love it. I love seeing you smile as you talk about this. It was obviously a very good time. But at the core of this conversation, we were talking about what makes the greatest athletes in the world great. If that is a subject that interests you, you can see In Search of Greatness. It is in theaters today.